Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate how you can use patterns in ACE version 13. So in version 13, a new restyled patterns gallery has been added, which has a very similar look and feel to the tutorials gallery. Patterns are reusable solutions which encapsulate a tested approach to solving a common architecture, design, or deployment task in a particular context. At first, patterns and tutorials look pretty similar. Both are helpful, in particular to new users or those who want to get a solution up and running quickly. A tutorial provides a fixed set of resources to show a running example. A pattern presents you with a set of choices which allow the generated resources to be customized, which fit in the way that you want to use them. You can see that there are five categories shown here: protocol transformation patterns, enterprise integration patterns, format transformation patterns, messaging patterns, and scatter gather patterns. The purpose of a pattern is to allow the user to provide some property values and some key facts about what they want to do in their integration solution. The artifacts are then dynamically generated, which match with those values which were provided. For example, if you're looking to have a solution which converts from one format to another, you could use one of the format transformation patterns and choose the style of transformation that you want, and the generated artifacts would be created and use the values that you provided. This enables you to very quickly create some solutions which are extremely useful to new users of a product. It's also actually very helpful for users who want to have consistency in the way that flows are developed. The patterns are hosted publicly on GitHub, so it allows the ACE development team to make changes outside of a standard release cycle of a product. So when we have a next set of patterns ready to be used, they can just go live at any stage. The patterns that are listed here in the grey background are available in ACE version 13.0.1. The patterns that are in the blue background will be provided in future mod releases of version 13. So let's go through an example. There is a patterns link here in quick starts. In fact, if I go to the welcome page, there's also a link to the patterns gallery from the welcome page as well. So if I click on patterns, the patterns gallery is shown. I can specify a tag. So for example, if I want to transform from JSON to XML, I can specify JSON as a tag. And I can specify XML as a tag. And then I can scroll down this list and I can select the JSON to XML pattern. And then once I've selected it, there is a picture of the type of flow that will be created, a brief description. If I click the Start button, the pattern will be downloaded and installed. A window is shown where I need to trust the artifacts. So I can click on the button to trust the artifacts. And now the pattern is being installed. So this is an Eclipse plugin which is being installed. And now a wizard is shown which will allow me to create an instance of this pattern. And I can specify a name. So I'll call it JSON to XML. And now I am guided through some steps to configure the flow which will be generated. So here it's asking me to confirm the path suffix is giving me a default value. I will go with this default value and click Next. Now I'm being asked if I want to enable validation or disable it. I will continue with the default. And here I can specify the fault format. By default, it has JSON selected, so I will keep with that default value. And now I can select the type of mapping. So I can select a compute node, or a Java compute node, or a mapping node. In this example, I'm happy to use a mapping node, so I will go with that value. And now I can click the generate button so that the instance is generated. So now my instance has been generated. You can see there is a new application with the generated flow. There are some instructions here on how to run the flow. I'm just going to open up the message flow that was generated. And I can see that the flow has been created. If I open up the mapping node, I can see that the output domain has been configured to be set to X, Y, and C for me. So I can test the flow by using the flow exerciser. So if I click on the record button, I can deploy the message flow. And sample input message is provided. So I'm going to click send. And here I can see that the input message was JSON, and it has been transformed to XML. So in this video, I have described how you can use patterns. I've shown the new patterns gallery and the different types of patterns that can be installed.